wasn't going to tell me to do it, so I just threw my wife under the bus. It's all I didn't. So those of you that don't know the actual story, so the Beatles finished the 1966 tour in August, whatever it was, 27th or 29th of 1966. That's it, we're done. We're tired of being the Beatles and touring. We just want to go to the studio. We just want to make great records. And so they took a vacation. John went to Spain, and that's where he wrote Strawberry Fields Forever when he was working on a movie called How I Won the War for Richard Lester, where he played a private gripweed. And so when they reconvened to record in 1966, John brought his song in, Strawberry Fields, and they started working on it. And I'm assuming Paul at that point, you know, heard that John's written a song about his childhood. Strawberry Fields was the orphanage by his home. And so Paul decides, well, I'm gonna write my song with my childhood, and that became Penny Lane. And they recorded When I'm 64 around that time, and they started making the record that became Sgt. Pepper. Well, the EMI record label, they needed a single, because, you know, you gotta keep the cash cow going, right? So they took Strawberry Fields and Penny Lane and released their first double A-sided single, right? Which ironically was the first single that didn't go to number one in England. Do you know the song that kept it from going number one? Please release me and you. Engelbert Humperdinck. My mom's favorite line. You. I didn't realize how much he sounds like Dean Martin. That's my dad's favorite. Everybody knows somebody sometimes. They're all just trying to be Bing Crosby. Next time I play, I promise I'll just croon the whole night. You're probably tired of this guitar stuff. But I'm in it now. I'm gonna try to do it anyway. Right? So, there's horns, there's all kinds of orchestrations, there's a piccolo trumpet, there's flutes, and I just got six strings and nervous two hands. So. But I'm gonna try, look at those guys on the set, making the promo films, being as cool as anybody could possibly be. But the girls were all put off because they grew mustaches for the first time. You can see them debut Strawberry Fields on Dick Clark, American Bandstand. The girls were like, they look old with mustaches, man. I'm for the guitar, stay for the useless knowledge here. Thank you. much. So there's the track by Ojib.